Previous lessons in relation to your golf bodies and how it reacts to your start position with your golf grips. So keep in mind here, if you have an incorrect grip where you've got the V's going in the opposite direction, in order for me to square this club up, you notice here it's way open or the heel is winning the race. If my right hand takes over, you'll notice that the toe wins the race, but you'll notice my body's now getting contorted by quite a bit. So I'm reacting to my start position for my hands, as opposed to if I've got the correct start position where down on my fingers both V's are going in the same direction. As I make these mini swings, you'll notice not only is the club face getting squared up easily, but I'm not making a whole bunch of extraneous body movements to be able to square that club face up. So now as we look at our golf bodies, they're symmetrical, just as many parts on this side as on this side. So as I swing back to where the club is at, let's say 9 o'clock or parallel to the ground, you'll notice that my left arm is fairly straight and my right arm is starting to fold. Now as I swing back around, hopefully that same thing happens. So as I go this way, hopefully my right arm straightens up and my left arm begins to fold. Well, a lot of you, because of your grips, either too much in the palm, or maybe now you've corrected it, but you haven't worked enough on your grip pressure, and now you're still gripping too tight with the left arm. Now as you take this thing back, again, right arm folding, left arm straight, but as I come through here, you'll notice that I've got so much tension on my left arm, it never gives itself a chance to, again, there's that emergency brake, to give up and let the toe win. So as I look at my club face, you notice that the heel is winning the race over the toe. Ball goes left to right for the right-handed golfer. At some point, I've got to let this left arm relax and fold, and look what happens immediately as soon as I let this left arm fold and relax. Look what happened to the club face. It squared right up, didn't it? There's the tension. Again, there's the big slice. Heel wins the race over the toe. As soon as I let my arm fold in and relax, look what happens to the club face. It squares right up. So as you work on your golf grips, again, keep in mind, do this outside or away from lamps or away from your kids or dogs or anything like that. Let's work on our grip. Down in the fingers. Lifeline swings right in, covers up the left thumb. I can now feel the weight of that club as much as I can. I get set up in there, I get myself nice and relaxed, I just take it back to about parallel or 9 o'clock on the clock again. Right arm, left arm fairly straight, right arm's folded, and now as I swing through, you'll notice that right arm is straight and left arm is starting to fold or give up. So as I take a full finish here, and I'm going to try to keep it in here where it's smaller, you'll notice that it gives up. And then I'm able to get to a full finish and my arm relaxes. If you notice yourself back behind here with this chicken wing, then you know you probably have too much grip pressure here with this left arm, as opposed to letting it just fold right up underneath, and now you can't see my left arm until I do finish the golf swing. So work on your grips as much as you can. Again, it's winter time. You don't have to see any results. Get that grip. Get those arms soft. Get your grip pressure so it's even. And then just take these little mini swings where you're feeling this as much as you can. Looks like a chip shot, but you can notice I'm starting to give up on my left side, folding over, and again, now my club head is getting squared up as opposed to that fashion. So with that, that's this week's golf tip. Next week, we're probably going to work a little bit more on your stances. We're going to need a bar stool because we're going to use that to get ourselves set up correctly. With that.